Well, first, a warning to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander viewers. This next story contains the name and image of someone who is deceased, and his family has given us permission to show him. Musician and activist Archie Roach has passed away after a long illness. The Gunditjmara Bundjalung senior elder was an inspiration to the end. He was 66.
The children away.
He was the voice of the stolen generations.
At 15, I left my foster home, looking for the people I call my own.
Taken from his family at just three, Archie was raised in Melbourne by foster parents. Wrongly told his parents had died, it was only as a teenager he discovered the truth.
You think about your life and you think about what happened to you and you feel a bit miserable, and, you know, being taken away as a kid and nobody giving you any answers why that was.
Archie battled the bottle for a decade, living rough when he met the love of his life, Ruby Hunter.
She had that spirit, that nurturing spirit, that mother spirit, where she'd always, you know, she'd forsake herself to look after me and our children.
I had no choice, it was there to be.
Through music, the pair turned their lives around.
Then they took the children away, took the children away.
People said, "Don't you get sick of singing that song, Arch?" I said, "Nah." You see, every time I sing it, I let a little bit of it go. So that's the power of music.
It was that song, Took the Children Away, that held a spotlight to the trauma visited upon generations.
His voice, his music and his story came out of pain but was informed by hope.
He sang for his people, but he also sang in a way that made white Australia understand.
An 8-time ARIA Award winner, Archie performed to the end at his 2020 induction into the ARIA Hall of Fame.
Yes, I came back.
He moved the room to tears. Archie Roach, songman, truth teller, a healing voice that will echo through time.
Like my brother before me, I'm a tent boxing man.
He had more songs to sing. He had more work to do, and yet he's taken from us now.
It's a good life. But, you know, it's like, you know, a bad start. You know, but, you know, you come good.
Rally round the drum, boys. Rally round the drum.
Well, Uncle Jack Charles worked closely with Archie Roach as an ambassador for his foundation, and he joins us now. Jack, Archie was a great mate of yours. First of all, our sincere condolences. How will you remember him?
I'll remember him as one of the... a giant, a moral giant here in Australia and indeed around the world. And we're all going to be, you know, sadly missing him. His records, his EPs will live on forever. But I am shocked at his passing, because only a week before, he was at Collingwood Town Hall on Sunday doing his show there, his final show.
Uncle Jack, he knew his health was failing in recent times, and
he did do that.
And
he did,
you know,
that.
You point out he kept performing right to his last days. He'd suffered
the very
so
last
much.
Moment, Hugh. The very last moment, and that takes a lot of gumption. That takes a lot of of energy.
So this is a kind of the mystery to me. It's almost like the sacred mystery of the man. He'd suffered so much pain.
Yes.
And yet somehow, including, of course, the loss of his beloved wife back in 2010, Ruby.
Yes, yes.
How was he able to somehow convert that suffering that he carried? He never made a pretense he didn't have it, and yet deliver so much support and so much communion with people right across Australia.
Well, he never forgot, Hugh, those that are struggling in our youth detention centres. He and I would go into the youth detention centres on Nadoc Week without fail. He was having his momentary lapses of health where he had to pull up and have a rest, but nonetheless, you know, he just kept on going right to, as we saw, to the very end.
Jack, what would it have meant to Archie to see the Prime Minister commit to constitutional recognition for Indigenous Australians?
Oh, he would have been over the moon if it ever happened, if it does happen. He was a man for many, you know, a man of many seasons, a man for many people. And so he was renowned the world over, but especially to all Australians, every Australian's. We'll have taken a moment to reflect on Archie's life and the impact that he had on the music industry.
Uncle Jack, to hear that news this morning, I think so many people would have just been heartbroken to have lost that incredible voice in both musical and a community voice that took care and supported so many. What do you think Archie's legacy will be?
I hold him closely to my heart. You know, one of the great things about being in this legend's presence, when he finally asked me to sing We Won't Cry song, do the Paul Kelly bits that Paul Kelly used to do, well, he asked me to do them. And it was the highlight of my life. You know, the bald legend and the feral legend singing We Won't Cry together was a hoot for so many. Mm-hmm. It was a winning combination.
Well, Uncle Jack, we know it's an incredibly tough time at the moment, and we really thank you for sharing your memories of Archie with us tonight.
Thanks, Lisa.